of his lady girl.
He's sort of a t-shirt and jeans kind of guy.
He's going for a mountain man look, which means
wants to be a
freak show. He has these overgrown claw-like tentacle feet.
That's very common amongst the dancers and the skaters.
Country toes.
On one hand, we have Rome glamour gorgeous. On the other hand, we have Alabama country toes.
First of all, he should have set up like a beautiful home for her.
Well, you know what? They're always on the road. They travel many, many weeks out of the year, and they have no place to come home to.
They've been together for married for 4 months. They've been together for six years.
Okay, it's time to make a nest, isn't it?
We're gonna have him take care of her just this once.
It's like Ice Castles meets Roman Holiday.
John, you're a lucky man, brother. She is gorgeous.
Who decorated your house? Like a couple of old people? These are horrible!
Sylvia and I made them.
These are delightful.
What are all these?
Wedding presents.
Wedding presents.
Wedding presents.
Why don't we have a little bridal shower later?
Oh, God, are these the country toes?
Are you sure you want to see those?
We want to go there.
You're prepared? Uh-oh.
Whoa!
These toes look like they haven't been cut since the Civil War.
There's room for improvement here.
I agree.
You agree?
Okay.
Oh, look what I found. So you guys are into soft porn.
Oh, my God.
I heart your plates.
And this is Sylvia's cooking.
Now, when did you make this?
She made that last night.
Ooh,
she made it.
Hey, put that down.
What is
that? Is that the Olympic torch?
Yes.
This is beautiful.
Can I take this to the Roxy on Saturday?
Delicious.
Your dining room table is bigger than your dining room. Is that weird? Did you guys not measure?
See if I can squidge in here. I'm dieting.
Is that any way to treat your product and your razor?
Kyle's like a bathroom Nazi. He's kind of a nightmare.
I'm Nancy.
You be Nancy. You're coming off the ice.
Oh, God! Yes.
Let's go in and look at your couture, shall we?
Hey, I might need to talk to Sylvia a little about interior design. As you can tell, we're having some problems.
So there is way too much casual clothing in here. Sweatpants, track pants, sweatshirts. Here's a little tip for you.
Tell me.
When buying the matching velour tracksuit, stop. Put it back on the rack.
If your apartment smells so bad that you have to plug it in,
that's a bad situation.
And this says Camici.
Shirt in Italian.
Camici. Camici.
Right.
And Camici.
You
just bought four shirts called Shirt. It doesn't get any more generic than that.
They're like really gay guns, aren't they?
Yeah, they're really gay.
We need to get you some grown-up clothes, some sophisticated clothes, when you go out on a date with her so you look like you belong with her.
Okay, because I don't think I do.
Now, what about John? What's his cooking like?
Like that. That's it.
Oh, no.
Better.
Do you want to make this change?
Yeah, I could probably. I'd like to make her feel a lot more feeling like I'm there for her on all ways, you know.
Bye.
Sorry, ma'am.
So when did you get married?
So we got married in August.
How did you ask her to marry you?
I took her to Central Park.
Oh, romantic.
And we did a little walk and broke down and cried and then asked her for...
Oh, stop.
And asked her to marry me.
I love colors, and John loves more earth-tone colors, and we try to
mix both
our tastes.
Jay.
Yes?
Jay. Send him to Central Park.
Oh, that'd be great.
A romantic night, and we will dress you up like the Prince Charming that you really are.
This soap is kind of hard to stay on. You're like...
Yeah, exactly.
Isn't it?
Sometimes it's hard to look in the mirror. It's probably not hard for you to look in the mirror because you're gorgeous.
How'd you guys fall in love, or how'd you know that you loved him?
It was just his personality was just so comforting, and he was my angel. So, of course, I loved him.
You don't use this. No.
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 Oh, are we having a bridal shower?
Why are all your wedding gifts still wrapped up in boxes in the middle of the floor?
We got married in August, and then John has gone to rehearsals for Stars and Ice, and I've been traveling all over Europe.
So there's just been no time?
Most guys cannot wear their hair long. They look ridiculous. Yeah. You actually look really good with the long.
So let's, the same.
No, I like the long hair.
Here's some lipstick for you. It's just really pretty.
Oh, snap. I'm allergic. It's generic.
I found John's schedule. This is crazy. You return from your honeymoon on September 14th.
Yeah.
A week later, he's got a fundraiser. 2 weeks for rehearsals. Yeah. Muckers on Ice. Brian Boitano skating spectacular.
We're going to be doing that together. We're going to for the first time skate together.
Talking with Sylvia is awesome. Like, her face lights up every time she mentions your name.
I love Sylvia with all my heart, and I want to find other more expressive ways of showing her how much I love her and showing her how much I think about her and care about her.
Why is it hard for you to skate together?
We can really skate around a lot together, being close without hugging. Oh, let's hug, let's kiss.
I thought it'd be fun if we got Sylvia a gift. We're going to go something a little unexpected and probably something she wouldn't expect you to go for, but I know it's something that she really loves.
To me, that would be the coolest because sometimes I feel like I just can't. You know, maybe I tried too hard and I can't come up with anything.
Okay, these slippers were made for walking, Sylvia. We got to give you your walking papers.
Okay. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Thank you so much for coming.
Oh, look at this cute little backpack.
Oh don't.
My God.
Ciao. Stop, ciao. Oh, thank God she's gone.
Yeah.
All right. Finally. Take your clothes off.
Some beer. Let's go get some beer.
He's a feisty rascal, this one.
Oh. Sylvia tells me that she does most of the cooking.
I don't know. I don't do a whole lot of things for her, though, in the kitchen. I mean, I could probably do a little bit more.
It might be kind of cool to do a romantic dinner.
Look at all the ointments I found.
Oh, my God.
It's like ointment central around here.
He's got a dry vagina on his hands.
Because we travel so much, we never have a chance to just sit down and enjoy a really good home-cooked meal. And I'd like to be able to give back to her and surprise her that way. I think it would be pretty cool.
This is a beautiful manicure. Idea.
What are we doing here, boys?
You know, wait a minute.
Oh, I'm sorry. I had no idea I was that close.
You can never have too much SPF.
So what's your vision of the space?
Well, you're trying to go modern. The first thing we thought about was always modern was chrome and black
right,
and
right.
glass and stuff like that.
Ooh,
and
looks like a dentist's office in like
right.
Boca.
Exactly. And so we were never feeling comfortable.
Right.
And I still want to be able to have that comfort, but have the look.
Right.
You know, so
right.
It's about the comfort and the look.
I found the porn though.
You did?
You did?
Oh, wait, let's see.
Uh-huh.
That's hardly porn, though. It's like from the Church of Latter-day Saints or something.
Yes. Oh.
I feel like this room should have a bed in it with an IV next to it and, like, all the equipment and, like, a fluorescent light over here.
John, this is the most boring porn I've ever seen.
What
ever.
All right, we have a long day ahead of us. You guys have to leave. Get the hell out of here.
Okay. Oh,
no.
Bye.
Here we go.
Get out, 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 get out,
Sylvia, I think she wants something a little bit more than that.
More hip, more to what's cool at the moment, and less country style, less cowboy-like.
So this is your work clothes, is what you wear all the time?
Yeah.
So what do you wear like when you go out?
Pretty much the same thing, because I'm tired, I'm worn out.
He's aching.
Aching.
Yeah. That's why your house smells like Bengay all the time. That's
yeah.
I'm going to take you to Emporio Armani. We're doing kind of a whole Italian theme. It's,
yeah.
I think it's kind of sweet because we're kind of doing an homage to Sylvia.
Yeah. Gosh, she's so cute and sweet. I just want to give her a big hug.
I just want to squeeze her.
I'm going to let you guys off right here so you can run in.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
See you in a bit.
Bye, have fun. Hey, don't let him touch you in your private area.
Gotcha.
He likes to do that. Bye.
Armani. They've got all sorts of great clothes for Lomos. I know it sounds like homo, but it's Italian for man. You have all the casual wear. You don't need any more of that. What you need is sophisticated clothing for to show respect for our little Sylvia.
That's what I need.
The love of your life. Let's make fashion happen.
Where do we start?
I'm just going to load you up. So the date tonight, I'm seeing a carriage ride in Central Park. I'm seeing a hot beverage. I'm seeing cuddling. I'm seeing tender, tearful moments, maybe.
It could be like that. Getting heavy.
Well, you'll be fine. These are very, very light. Okay. Don't forget the denim. Oh, the cashmere top coat. Really important for tonight. Okay, I've got this. Don't worry about me. Let's go to the fitting room. All righty. Just drop them right there. Who said shopping isn't good cardio? Now, do you shave your legs?
No.
No? Just gets rubbed off from all the lycra, I guess. Okay, this is looking good. This is looking real good. You're gonna look so great in the skull cap. What you wanna do when you're dressing, and I know you have to... Is this hot in here, or is it just you? Look out, Brian Boitano. There's a new kid in town. Take the sweater off. And let's try it in black. What you want to do when you're dressing, if you have a really sophisticated, interesting pant with a lot of detail, you wear it with a simple shirt, okay? Because you want to do simple, sophisticated, or sophisticated, simple, you don't want to do too much. We're on the top coat because you're going to be out tonight in Central Park. I think this is the outfit for tonight. The American judge gives you a 10.0. Hello. Okay, done. Get this stuff wrapped up.
We're here at Maurice Valencia. Oh my God, I'm gonna bust a gut. Come on in, pumpkin.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Eric. How are you? Our crazy straight guy.
Good to
John.
See you.
I'll show you one thing real quick. It's kind of cool. Let me tell you why I think this is cool for you.
Okay.
First of all, you have really low ceilings, so I want the sofa to be really low and kind of sleek. And Sylvia loves very, very clean, kind of sleek, modern Italian stuff. And this is that sort of look. You can sit on here.
I like this.
And you know, let me show you this coffee table. Now, are these little low coffee tables kind of freaking you out at all?
No, I like
you like
these
this?
A lot, actually.
I love them. I think they're really great. I mean, you should see their apartment. It is literally, it's so scary.
It was a mismatch, hodgepodge of
trying
to be modern and not being successful at it.
Right. And that's why I wanted to bring you to here, because this is the kind of furniture that you were sort of envisioning, but it wasn't what you actually had gone out and sort of selected.
Yeah.
All right, this is the whole accessory area. Don't you love it? And see all the color?
It's amazing, yeah.
I want to go look at these chairs. Hang on, let's go look at these. Oh my God, they're so comfortable. Wow,
ooh,
really comfortable.
Some of the colors we have are so like primary colors, and it gets kind of too headachey, I think.
Right.
They're bold, but they're not super.
Yeah, they're very sophisticated. I actually really like that. Isn't it cool?
Yeah, pillow brings it in.
Yeah, it kind of ties it all together.
Yeah, that's cool.
I think it's gonna look great. All right, kids, we gotta go. We've got a busy day. And I've gotta get back to their house and paint the pink polka dots on the walls.
Come on already, we've gotta tell you
the price.
Okay, so this is DePaulo's. My friend Louie is gonna tell us what we need to do to set you up with a fantastic Roman ravioli.
Okay.
For the lovely Sylvia. Louie, how are you, my friend?
Nice to see you.
This is our latest victim, John.
Hey, how you doing, John?
How you doing, Louie?
Okay.
He's got this fantastic, brand new wife. They've been married for 4 months. She does all the cooking. John is willing to try, he just hasn't got the chops yet, right?
Yeah, I need to get a little bit more acclimated to the kitchen.
What we're gonna do, Louis got, there are three cheeses in this ravioli.
The typical ravioli in Rome is usually a large size. Usually they serve one, sometimes two on a plate. The major ingredient to the good ravioli is our fresh sheep's milk ricotta. So you're going to have a slightly sweet, rich, buttery flavor.
Yeah, it's great stuff. And that'll be the primary, that'll be most of the filling, right. Mostly ricotta.
Right.
The second cheese that you're going to put in is what we call Cajo di Roma, cheese of Rome, or a table sheep's milk cheese. And finally, the ancient cheese of Italy, the Pecorino Romano.
Now, Louis, he's not going to need that whole block, right?
No.
So it's mostly going to be primarily ricotta, and then somewhat less of the Cajo di Roma, and then just
even less.
A few tablespoons of this.
And adding one more ingredient is fresh spinach.
Do you think she'll recognize these traditional ingredients from her family?
She's very aware of the different cheeses.
You know, the last thing we lose in our heritage is the foods. We lose the language very quickly, all right? We lose the customs, the way they dress.
I know she'll appreciate that.
All righty.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, my friend.
All right.
I appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you.
All the lessons and the food.
Well, it's my pleasure.
All righty, let's go. Come on, John, we got a whole bunch of other stuff to do here.
Let's do it. This is Juvenex.
Hey, Michael.
Hello.
Good to see you.
How are you? Good to see you.
You doing okay?
I brought you here because we had to do something about your feet. He has country toes. That's what his wife calls it, country toes. And basically, they're some of the scariest toes you've ever seen. So where do you want us to go?
Okay, great. I'll lead you to the locker room where you could change into robes and something more comfortable and pick it from there.
Cool.
Let's go.
When you have gnarly feet, women notice, so you have to take care of them, especially for you. You ask a lot of your feet, you know. They're going to give your legs and your feet a lot of love.
Okay.
And you get much more than just a pedicure. It's a whole treatment.
Okay, gentlemen, we're just going to have you each lie on your back, face at that end.
Which is that?
This is the anti-fluid gel. It helps really reduce muscle ache, tension in the legs.
Do you come and do these sorts of things a lot, like get massages?
I don't as much, right. But when I was training for the Olympics.
So you just trained
in fifth, is that right? We came in fifth. It would have been nice to get the medal, but really the medal, just like Sylvia said for herself, we both had performance in our heart, and that's what did it. And so
she's an amazing woman. She's really amazing.
I want to do the best things I can for her and for us to live here. I want her to feel like, I don't want her to abandon her home and her family, but sometimes I think maybe I could do more, you know, I could be maybe a little more creative in the ways I can let her know I'm thinking of her. But, you know, the whole thing about our lives together is just the journey, I think, being together. And
you guys have a lot to learn from each other.
Yeah.
Well, I can see your difference in your feet from here.
Are you true?
This is Amy Kaplatsel, International Head of Contemporary Art for Christie's.
Hi, how do you do?
As you can tell, we're in a gallery.
Yeah.
This is Andrew's gallery, and I wanted to bring you here because you said you were looking for new and interesting ways to say I love you. My favorite unexpected gift, art. So okay. Let's take a little walk. Going to a big gallery is sometimes overwhelming. Guys, straight guys we work with, they're like, I can't be artistic. I don't know what looks good.
Right.
Like, what's your answer to that?
I think the thing to focus on today when we look at these works is to focus not on maybe what's, quote, conventionally beautiful, but rather, is it meaningful? And most of what we're going to see today are going to be works on paper.
Okay, very good.
Let's take a look at some of this stuff.
Check it out.
Great. These are works by an artist called Ruth Rude. All of Ruth's work has this incredibly deep color. Now we're at Elif Europe, and these are a couple of drawings that are studies for her paintings. So this is a city of some kind with a twirly highway in front. I just think it has a sense of infinity that's amazing to me.
Those are very nice. I like those.
What has really spoken to you?
I'm torn between these two because I think the affinity and the horizon speaks about hopefully our love and who we are together and enduring relationship. At the same time, the glider, I think, feels like something that these two are flying silently through the air, and I feel like they're off to a happy place. And I feel like, no, that's where we are going.
Lucy, what a romantic.
And I think it's a good starting block. All right, well, it's been great. I've enjoyed meeting you guys. Thank you so
great
much for your
you.
Time.
Good luck.
There he is.
Pink right. polka dot. Pink polka dot.
Pink polka. Don't hit the nope. stroller.
Hello.
Oh, my God.
Hello. Love it.
John and Sylvia's apartment needs a lot of help. Everything's sort of stuffed in a box. Papers thrown all over the place.
Definitely bachelor style. The painting job didn't really come out as we expected it.
You just want to take everything that they have and basically pitch it. Definitely does not say, come in, welcome.
Being a young couple, I think a contemporary, modern but warm apartment would really fit our stage in our life.
Hey, so tell me about what you did today.
You had a pedicure?
We got the whole pedicure thing going. I think we are seeing the last of the country toes.
So tonight's gonna be fun.
I think tonight's gonna be awesome. I got some great plans with her. We're gonna start off with an incredible dinner that Ted, you helped organize for us.
And then you're going back to Central Park. We're gonna give you some liquid courage so maybe you can keep your emotions in check this time. Here we go. All right.
I am psyched. Let's do it.
Wait to see what he's done this time.
Let's
finish
right here. Close your eyes.
Okay, here we go.
Can you do it?
Uh-oh.
How you doing?
How are you doing?
There he is.
Oh, no.
Keep
pink polka dots. Right. Think pink polka dots.
Pink polka dots. Don't hit the nope. stroller.
Hello.
Oh, my God.
Did you love it?
Wow.
Oh, my God.
This is incredible. Wow.
Sylvia was telling me that you wanted everything to be sort of monochromatic and earth tones, and that she wanted a lot of color.
I think you blended both of us in there, and certainly the furniture is right. very contemporary.
What she expressed to me, this was it, and then you wanted basically the same thing, but you wanted to do it with less color, and I think this is a perfect balance. Guess where this is from? IKEA. Can
really?
You believe that? It was less than this pillow. All your Olympic stuff is kind of mixed in. There's like wedding stuff, family stuff.
I cool. can't wait to show
yeah,
Sylvia.
Yeah, you think she'll
this
like it?
This is just
she's
cool.
gonna I think yeah. she's going to really like this it. Okay, let me show you the dining room.
This is incredible.
Yeah, it just turns it into like a wall of glass. Like, yeah. it's like this illusion that there's like just glass all behind these. Oh. The thing is that the curtains not only work better and look better, but they make the apartment feel much warmer. And I mirrored this with just, these are really inexpensive glue-on yeah. mirrors.
Really opens up the place.
It totally opens it up.
Enough.
We're gonna do a Roman-style ravioli, and we're gonna start, before anything else, with the basic marinara sauce. And it starts off with onions that are gonna be sauteed in butter. So cook the onions until they're soft and translucent, then we put in the whole tomatoes. Simmer this for 15 or 20 minutes. So let's go move over to the pasta making situation. What we have in this bowl is 3.5 cups of bread flour, and what you do is take 5 eggs, and then I would probably get in here with my hands and knead it. After you get it mixed, you have to let it rest for 30 minutes to an hour before you can actually roll it out flat on the pasta machine.
Okay.
So I've gone ahead and made some. This is the classic pasta machine. What you have to do with this stuff is roll it out into successively thinner pieces, all right? So we'll start at the biggest setting.
Okay.
There you go, start rolling. Not too fast. Yeah, step it down to the next smallest settings. Yeah, I usually can jump to 2 and see how that gets nice and thin. Okay, so what we have here is our mixture of cheeses. So you put a nice, healthy dollop of your filling. Take a little bit of water on a brush, okay? You're gonna brush in between here. This is what's gonna help your pasta to stick to itself. So, I'm gonna take this guy, and I'm gonna put him on here like this. Start on one edge, all right? You want to try to press out any air that's in here. And then, very easy, just voila, voila. So there you go.
Okay.
Nice, big, beautiful ravioli. Fresh pasta cooks really quickly, so this will be ready in 3 or 4 minutes. Let's drop the pasta. I'll throw them in there. And these are really delicate, so I'm stirring the water, but not touching the ravioli themselves. Okay, meanwhile, you want to have like a tomato cream sauce. Okay. So just take that marinara as just the basic starting point, add just a little bit of cream at the end.
Okay.
Now, if you would be so kind as to carry that to the table.
Give this a shot.
We gotta make Louis proud.
Yeah, cheers.
Cheers.
I think we did it. Excellent job.
I think I gotta hand you off to our doctor of fashion.
Oh, God.
Dr. Carson Kressley.
Oh, no.
Everyone get on the bed. First of all, let's get naked. So, he had all this great kind of athletic wear that he was wearing to and from the rink, but it didn't fit and it was way too casual. So I want to mix and match kind of technical sportswear, which you have a lot of, and dress it up. So we're going to take a tuxedo shirt from Emporio Armani, and these pants are from Victorinox. But look how sexy that is when you take true sportswear and dress it up with the rugged, with the beautiful tuxedo shirt.
That would be a great look on ice.
All right, movie star.
I should have done this for the Olympics.
Okay. 10 from the Lithuanian judge.
All right.
I just have to leave a little room.
9.8, jealous. 8.5.
Puerto Rico gives you a 9.0 because I know Carson generally saves the best for last. So.
This is his skating outfit. We did a heat transfer of a tiger's head on leather. And we just made this up for you, custom made.
This is incredible.
It's, I would not recommend this for like, you know, a day in the park.
No. Judges?
Judges?
A million 50, people.
Do you have a gay brother?
Is that mine? Yes, that's yours.
Yeah. I got him a t-shirt on Armani that says Rome on it. I think you should wear this when Sylvia comes home, okay? Because it's just cool, it looks great wearing around the house. Done.
This is a gift certificate for you from Juvenex. And one of the pools, one of the dipping pools that they have is a ginseng bath. It's a cool ginseng bath. And so they sent a little bit of ginseng soap just for you to try out. And then this is like the major deal right here is this bathtub.
Sanctuary.
I created the ambience and the atmosphere, not only for nurturing, but for romance.
For all the hours of skating and putting out all the work, you need this to do it again tomorrow.
Absolutely. Tonight, I think you should go clean shaven. It's really great to exfoliate before you shave because it will prevent ingrown hair and razor bumps. I just want to show you how to use this facial scrub from Cole Design. Just put like a little bit of this in here, right?
So this is the pre-shave.
It's an exfoliating scrub. Okay. You can use it, I would use it once a week, whether you shave or not.
Okay.
However, if you've not shaven for a few days and you want to shave, it's great to exfoliate before you do that, okay? So then you just add a little bit of water, a little bit of the warm water. So now rinse your face with water. Take that and put it on your face and scrub it in. You feel it?
Oh yeah.
So what I want you to do is draw a hot bath and just relax for a second, okay? Because you want to center yourself. You're gonna have a really special night with your wife tonight. So give that to yourself and then hit, you know.
Get going.
Get in gear. Now let's just rinse with some water. So tonight, hot bath, and then go for the gold, my friend.
Excellent, good.
Okay, I think Jay is ready for you.
All right.
Come on in here. Do you remember this?
I do.
So we had this framed.
Incredible.
Wow. Okay, so this is something that we never picked up at the gallery.
Right.
The name of the drawing is called Travel is Happiness.
Wow.
So let's hang this bad boy, shall we?
All right.
Okay.
See, we have a place. That's really cool, man.
I normally wouldn't say this like this, but let's go back to your bedroom. One of the things that you said to me was that you wanted to learn how to show how much you loved your wife in very untraditional ways.
Mm-hmm.
So these are just some cute ideas. You can pop a towel in the dryer when she's just about to take a shower. And then when she gets out, you can hand her a nice warm towel.
Yeah. Maybe.
That's kind of nice,
that's
right?
A good one.
That's a good one, okay. One of my favorites is the best way to say I love you is just to do it. And to do it when the person's least expecting it. Because there are those romantic moments where you're in Central Park and it feels right and it's great and it happens. And then there's those untraditional times that you catch yourself looking at her and you're like, God, I love this woman.
Yeah.
And you know what I mean? And it's probably the best time to say I love you, I think.
Telling her how much I love her all the time is one thing, but showing it in action will help
you know, convey it without it being so contrived and so predicted.
It's been really fun.
Thanks a lot.
No problem. Thank okay, you. Let's go get the other boys. Come on.
All right, man.
Hey, come on, guys.
Ready to go?
Say goodbye.
Well, you guys should get a glass too for yourself.
Have a glass, Jay. I got a couple things for when you take your carriage ride. We've got some fantastic biscotti.
Perfect.
And then we have
for Sylvia.
For Sylvia also, we got this Viennese coffee, brandied coffee with Lindt chocolate. It'll be really nice in the carriage.
I think you guys really have sort of understood exactly where I was coming from and on all aspects of everything and what I feel and what I love for Sylvia. I'm very lucky, and Sylvia's very lucky, to be able to have this to start our lives together, and you guys, and we're very, very appreciative.
Thank you.
Cheers. Cheers.
Cheers. Hey,
we're
lucky.
Salute.
Salute. Salute.
Okay, we got a sprint.
All right.
We
gotta go.
All right, guys. Thanks, dude.
Goodbye.
Be good, guys. See you guys.
Bye.
Take care. Be safe.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Ooh, yeah.
Oh my gosh. You guys, he's kind of losing it.
This is not happening.
John's Italian. Niente. Zero. No, pochissimo.
John could improve in a lot of the areas that Sylvia loves and is very passionate about.
John, I think you just need to start embracing a little bit more of who she is and her culture.
Definitely. It's very gratifying for Sylvia if he can adapt more to her lifestyle. It would be nice for him to learn some of the aspects of my culture.
Let's go. We're ice skating. We're ice skating.
Who would like a lump?
I would like a lump.
I'm dying to see what she thinks about the new place.
Yeah, I can't wait to see this.
Here we go.
Oh, oh my God. Oh. He's gorgeous.
Taking a bath?
Yes, I told him to take a bath, to relax, to get into the mood.
Thumbs up for Kai and Douglas. And he's already pounding the liquor. An athlete after my own heart. Guys, I'm sensing a little stress. He's making ravioli from scratch.
That's not easy.
It's not easy.
Get some hair in the dough, it'll add extra fiber.
Yeah, we should have gotten in the hair net. Oh, guys, look, something's going wrong here. See, it's getting too skinny. It's all about width, it's not just length.
It's about girth.
Oh my gosh. You guys, he's kind of losing it.
This is not happening.
You can do it.
That's cute, though. At least he's having fun with it. Now, what is this? Is it cheese?
All right, this is a mixture of sheep's milk cheeses from the Roman regions.
Oh, God, look the way he pushes those cheeks in.
Now wait, this is nerve-wracking. He's cutting way too close to the filling, so it could explode in the pot. I hope not.
He's a little close to the pillow, if you will.
Yeah. He sure is putting away that Orvieto.
Yeah.
Next up, Betty Ford.
Ooh, my favorite time, bath time.
Oh, Lord. Hey, don't do that in there. You're going to ruin the water.
If I were in that bathtub, I would be scrubbing that back for him.
I wouldn't be scrubbing.
I wouldn't be scrubbing either.
There's very little product on his face. He's doing too fast. He's jabbing his face like that.
He's going sideways.
He's not taking care. Look at that. What kind of shaving is that?
I thought that he would look better with the scruff, but you were totally right. She's going to be so clean and kissable.
You know why we shaved it? It was for her. Yeah. It was all about her.
Mm. All right. Someone's early.
Oh, God.
Hey, baby. Hey,
baby. He looks so
bad. Oh, God.
Bellissima.
It's so unfair.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. How did they do that?
I know, man.
Oh, we're magic.
This is exactly how I love, you know, the style like I loved.
I'm so happy she loves it.
One.
Absolutely. Yay.
I want you to take a look at this. I want you to tell me what you think about this drawing.
We're flying home. We have a home to fly to.
Oh.
You made their house a home.
It's something that I felt that kind of represented you and me, because there's two people in this glider. And the glider itself represents, I think, an effortless movement towards something that we want to be at one day.
Oh my God. I'm just like...
Just shoot me, please.
Okay, what
look
do you
at
think?
Look at the couture.
Now this is just a little appetizer.
Right, absolutely.
Bye.
Look at the city.
Roma.
Roma.
Roma. She's inspecting.
Uh-oh, uh-oh.
Oh, my God.
Don't let her touch that spoon.
Look at that. She's jumping right in.
No. Don't touch, because this is all me about doing this for you.
Okay, so I can touch it.
I want you
to sit. Trying to get an Italian woman out of the kitchen is not easy.
See the look in his eyes? Oh yeah. My gosh.
That was carnivorous.
That was hot.
You look so cute being nervous for cooking. I can't get over it.
I'm not nervous, but do you want a glass of wine?
What? I'm not nervous, but do you want a glass of wine?
Salute. Salute. I love you so much.
I love you too, baby.
Thank you for doing this for me.
It hasn't even started yet. Don't worry.
Oh, I love him too.
I love you both.
Okay, the paper towels for the napkin is not really my...
That's one tragic flaw.
That's all right.
Is that cool?
Yeah.
Look how beautiful those are. He did a great job.
All right.
Thank you. Grazie, amore mio.
This is something Louis said to us. Is first thing when people move to the States...
Don't make me cry.
No. Is that a lot of times people will lose their... customs, lose their language. Okay, but they never lose their food.
Right.
It's the last thing that goes. Their food is something that they always hold tight to.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
I can't even deal.
I hope she's wearing waterproof mascara.
This is the beginning. We'll try to keep the traditions of the food at least staying all the time.
Oh, he's gonna keep this as a tradition. That's wonderful.
All right, tell me what you think.
Tomatoes taste so good.
It's the expressway to her heart, that pasta.
It was the best meal.
This is just the first of many dishes. I promise you, I'm gonna learn.
You'll cook for our kids this.
Right. He will make this for their kids.
Oh, there are little Zimmermans on the way. Oh, he's putting on the outfit for the date. The military pant, the cool Armani belt. He's gonna do the big kind of Cossack-inspired sweater.
You look great.
Oh my God, masculine. Gorgeous.
Oh my God. Ooh. Looks like she's taking the kids with her, too.
Yes, the Apenninos.
The girls are out.
Oh, this feels so good.
You feel so good. That's what I was going for. Cuddly. They should just stay home and make sweet, sweet love.
They really ought to, honestly.
Very cool.
How does that work?
Now we're ready to go into the city.
Now we're ready.
I love you, baby.
Oh, I love you too.
I want some of that.
What a gorgeous night out there, right?
Oh, beautiful.
So pretty. The stars, the horse.
Here we go.
We're gonna never see.
Welcome to Central Park.
Thank
Hi,
you very
Sylvia.
Much.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Just that pony's gonna be awfully mad that she's wearing one of his cousins.
I know.
Hey, don't get that acrylic near their clothes, please.
I know, right?
It's gonna peel.
You happy?
Very.
Is this exciting? Are you expecting this?
Yeah. I'm so excited. Aw, so cute.
Now, what's that?
That's biscotti.
Oh.
Oh,
I have one.
Absolutely.
Wow.
Hold that.
You have tricky things in that bag.
Yo, what is that?
They've got a brandy coffee also to sort of go with the biscotti.
Ooh, I love brandy.
Delicious.
Let's do an Italian version of the Fab Five.
Okay. Wait. Two. Two. I fantastici cinque.
to I fantastici
cinque.
Cinque. To the fantastici cinque.
That is so sweet.
Cheers. Cheers. Cheers.
Chin chin, my love. Chin chin.
I love you, baby.
They're delightful.
Oh, I love you too.
I want some of that. Oh. Now, where are they going, Jay?
I've set it up so they can skate, you know, with the other skaters and see the beautiful city skyline. Yeah, because they have the rink there, and it's beautiful
so
in the
romantic.
Winter with the skyline, and this is such a clear night. It's really ideal.
Look at this, Sylvia. Now, have you ever skated a woman rink?
Never.
They've never been skating here before.
No?
No.
Oh, it's talk about romantic. This is amazing.
I am
Would
not
you look
believing
at that?
This.
You know, they don't always skate together.
They never do.
Oh, yeah.
Cool.
Okay, you know, I'm getting a little emotional.
Oh, my God.
I kind of love this outfit, though. It's Armani on ice, but he looks Armani really butch.
Wait, the leg, the leg, the leg. Yes, get it! Wow.
That's handy.
Wow.
They suit each other beautifully,
they really
though.
Do. Oh, my gosh, that was so pretty.
Beautiful! That's a 10!
She feels like a princess.
Oh, she is a princess.
She is. She's an angel. They are breathtakingly beautiful. She's really become American. She speaks English fluently. She lives in this country. So she's really taking on our customs.
It's nice that she's done a lot of work to assimilate to his culture. He hasn't done a lot of work to kind of embrace her. So it's nice seeing him do that.
They're truly inspiring to start what they're doing, which is this life together. They're, you know, they probably both have these very warm families and homes. And now they have that sort of foundation to build.
It takes a homo to make a home. Thank you.
It takes a homo to make a home sometimes.
Well, kids, these guys were an inspiration to us all.
Yeah. I want to go out and find a soulmate. Come on, we have a little time.
Go.
We have to go out
to the Zimmermans, kids.
To the Zimmermans.
Massage is great, but it can be costly. An affordable alternative, do it yourself.
Massage increases blood flow
and flushes out toxins. Oh, harder. Harder.
If you want to be touched, wear fabrics that invite touch, like velvet, cashmere, and suede. Ooh, that tickles.
An art ledge is a great and creative way to display your art collection.
If you don't have a special occasion to celebrate with your mate, make one up. Don't waste time waiting to say, I love you.
There's a wrong way to test pasta, and a right way. Take it off the stove while it's still a little chewy. Mm. That's al dente, and that's delicious.